Alistair Cook would have been pretty satisfied with England's efforts in the field on day two, but New Zealand were still just about in the ascendancy at the start of play on Saturday. The tourists resuming on 153 for four, 79 runs behind England's first innings score, with Kane Williamson 44 not out and skipper Brendan McCullum on one. James Anderson had been England's most potent weapon with the ball, taking three of the four wickets to fall. But it was Stuart Broad who got England's day off to a good start, as he struck with just his third delivery of the morning. McCullum asking for a review, but failing to get the verdict he was looking for. A watchful Williamson kept the scoreboard ticking over for the tourists, as he became only the second player in the match to score a half century. However, he was on his way back to the pavilion just a couple of overs later as he glanced a leg side ball from Anderson into the grateful gloves of Matt Prior to go for 60. Tim Southee then put in an entertaining cameo, smashing three consecutive boundaries to make 12 before attempting another big hit two balls later and sending a Stephen Finn delivery down the throat of Joe Root. Anderson then produced the ball of the match so far to get rid of new man Bruce Martin without scoring. And two quick wickets from Finn then ensured England finished with a first innings lead. BJ Watling swinging and edging to go for 17. Before Trent Bolt departed without scoring. So certainly England's morning, as Anderson's 13th 5-4 in Test cricket helped them take New Zealand's final six wickets for just 54 runs and earn a lead of 25. Cook and Nick Compton had 10 minutes or so to negotiate before lunch, and there was a nervy moment for the England skipper early on. Bolt convinced Cook had edged behind, but the tourists were unsuccessful with their review. England reaching the break on 12 without loss, 37 runs ahead.